are starting on answer to a child's question, and we are starting in measure 88.
Where we have the beautiful Alto parts. How many of you have ever seen the original version of Cinderella? The cartoon version.
Yeah, I used to love that. I was the one that was
like the real story.
Okay, now, listen up. You know the part where Cinderella, let me back it up a little bit. Her stepsisters are up in the music room, like, singing and playing the flute.
Yeah.
And it's, like, really, really hard to listen to, right?
Yeah.
And then it kind of pans away from the music room and on to Cinderella, and she's she's on the floor, like, scrubbing the floors, and she's singing the same song that they were doing, except it's beautiful because it's Cinderella.
Cinderella's awesome.
Okay, and it goes into this whole, like, bubble scene where you see Cinderella and all these bubbles and singing all these harmonies with herself, right? And then she finishes singing. Well, she almost gets to the end of her song, and then that dang cat, Lucifer, has dipped his paws in the dustpan of all the dirt that she swept up and put dirty paw prints all over the floor she just scrubbed. Do you know what I'm talking about?
I think about cats.
This part of the song right here, the harmonies, the super tight harmonies that are in this part of the song, they totally remind me of that part in Cinderella where she's singing all those beautiful harmonies, right?
I've seen the cartoon version of Cinderella since I was five.
You haven't seen it?
Since I was five, no.
You should play it.
You should watch it right now.
The best part about the actual movie is her dress. I love the dress.
You should play
the real one. The real one.
Yeah, I like the dress.
Otherwise, I like the cartoon.
Okay, so here we go. Whenever we sing this harmony, I was talking to the sopranos about this very thing this morning. I want them to really lean into the melody, because right now we have a lot more students in this, well, not a lot more, but a few more students in this class than we have in that one, plus almost half of that class has been quarantined, but I really, really, really want you to lean into these gorgeous harmonies that you have right here, okay? So we're going to start right there, and we're going to practice those beautiful harmonies, okay? So here's what I need you to understand. You're going to have to supply these notes with tons of air. Do not try to muscle it down there. Do not try to look down at the notes. Okay, when you do this, you actually are 100% making it harder on yourself. Don't look down. Keep your chin level, okay? It's no different than reaching up like this for high notes. You put all this, my speaking voice, all the stress that's on it, right?
And it's the same whenever I do this. I put all kinds of weird stress on these muscles.
Keep everything level. Do not look down at those notes. Now she sings. And I am a soprano one. These are notes are low for me too, okay? So listen to me when I tell you. I have a few little ways that will make singing it easier. Lots of air. Lots and lots of space. Keep that chin nice and level. You might even kind of, there are times where I've had to do this myself, kind of put your hand underneath your chin because it's just human nature. You kind of start to look down on those low notes like it's going to help you and it doesn't, okay? So if you start to kind of look down, just tap your chin, keep it up. And, okay, so those are some things that are going to help you with these low notes. But we have some boys that can really help us out here, okay? So here we go.
Yeah, Jonathan.
Okay, because their part is going to move up. You're going to want to follow it. If it doesn't do loud and proud, yes?
Thank you. If you're online, the slideshow is posted on Canvas. Please answer the questions on the quiz and make sure to do your best. If you score high enough, you will be entered for a chance to win a $25 gift card to Sonic.
Hold that note for 2 beats. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, the sopranos are gonna move.